cruel. There's a wonderful essay by Yves Bonfoy about Rambo's mother, which I recommend dearly, and I agree with entirely. It's tough. Why were you born? Because of you. And on we go. Morning of drunkenness. Oh, my good. My beautiful. Atrocious fanfare. I've never once faltered. Magic rack. Hurrah for the unheard of poem, and now for the first time for its marvelous body. Hurrah! It began with the laughter of children. It will end there. This poison will be as strong as ever in our veins, even when the fanfare dies in the distance and we fall backwards into the very first discord. Having well and truly earned our tortures, let us now and fervently demand fulfillment of the godly promise made to our bodies and souls at the moment of their creation. This promise, this insanity, elegance, science, violence, these, it was promised, would bury the tree of good and evil in absolute darkness, would banish despotic proprieties, freeing us to love purely in the pure land. It began with disgust. It ends, since eternity will never be taken by storm, it ends in the rout and riot of perfumes. Laughter of children, modesty of slaves, austerity of virgins, horror of every face and object here. Blessed may ye be in memory of my vigil, ending now. It began with boorishness. It ends with angels of fire and ice. Little drunken vigil canonized. So what if saintliness is all a masquerade? We affirm thee, O method of the mask. We do not forget. You are the glory of the ages. We have faith in poison. We know very well how to waste our lives. Behold the time of the assassins. He was a bad boy. But I like that boy. This is pretty. Just to let you know that Artie could do pretty. Artie wasn't always pissed. Sometimes he was stoned. Dawn. And this, to me, the French word for dawn is the most beautiful word in any language. And I mean this with complete sincerity. Oh, it just seems to me a word that I like to wake up and say, oh, it's so vulnerable. And it's the prettiest word there is. So this is called dawn in English, but in the real language. French is a real language, by the way. English is one of those virtual languages. Oh, I kissed the summer dawn. J'ai embrassé l'aube d'été. I said to say that. J'ai embrassé l'aube d'été. I kissed the summer dawn.
Thank you.
No charge. In front of the palaces, nothing stirred. The lakes lay dead. An army of shadows slept on the forest road. I walked on, wakening the warm, live air. And the stones watched me. And wings rose up without a sound. What happened first was that in the cool, now shimmering path, a flower told me her name. I laughed at the blonde waterfall whose hair streamed down through the pines. At the silvery summit, I recognized the goddess. Then, one by one, I lifted her veils. In the path, waving my arms. In the flatlands, where I told the rooster she was coming. In the great city, she ran away among the steeples and the domes, and running like a beggar among the marble piers, I gave chase at a crest in the road near a grove of laurels. I gathered her up in a net of her own veils, and only then began to know her infinite body. Dawn and the child dove to the bottom of the wood. I woke at noon. And this last poem is called Youth, Jeunesse. Why do we speak English? It's so much work. Youth.
Oh, God.
You could herniate yourself.
Jeunesse.
We should rethink this whole English thing. And thank you so dearly for turning out so tenderly for these wonderful people, of whom I'm glad to be a camp follower. Youth. Homework done! Comes the inevitable descent from heaven, and the visit with memories, and the chamber music fills the rooms, and my head, and all my soul. A pony, stricken with plague, bolts and runs across suburban lawns and little gardens and woodlots. A hag, cut loose from a theater somewhere, sighs over non-existent lost loves. Desperados languish for want of rapine, drunkenness and bloodshed. Little children whisper obscenities on the towpath. In the noise of mob incitement and insatiable labors, let us resume our studies now. Man of ordinary build, was not your flesh an apple once, hanging in the orchard? Oh, childhood days, your prodigal body was a treasure to squander. Oh, to love, the peril or the power of psyche. Hillsides then were all the earth, and teeming with artists and princelings and bloodlines, and race drove us to crime and grief, the world your very good luck and your peril too. But nowadays, all labor's done. You, your calculus, you, your fits of rage are nothing more than a little song and dance, nothing permanent, nothing important. Nevertheless, reason enough and twice over for invention and successfulness and brotherly love and the tender humanness of a universe purged of images, justice and power, a little song and dance. Beloved, only now. The teachers' voices are gone into exile. Bodily candors, bitter, stale, adagio, ah! The infinite vanity of adolescence, the studious optimism. How full of flowers was the world that summer. Dying songs, vanishing shapes, a choir to banish impotence and absence, a choir of cups of night music. My nerves are shot. You're still stuck in the temptation of St. Anthony, the frolic of an interrupted fuck, your spastic, puerile pride, the terrors and tremors, and yet you will take up the task. All the harmonic and architectural possibilities will rise around you. Immaculate, unforeseen creatures will lay themselves down for your new pleasure. Wherever you stand inside a dream of ancient crowds and idle luxuries. Your memory and your five senses will be nothing but fuel for your creative impulse. And as for the world, once you have left it, what is it?